I would like to talk about my teacher, Mrs. Leek, from high school psychology. She also taught government, but she had really high standards for herself and for her students. And so, I mean, that was evident. She, while I was actually in her class taking, as she was teaching, they came in and gave her the Huntsman Award for Utah, which is the highest teaching award, and we all believe that she deserved it because she was constantly trying to work and learn, which is what she wanted us to do. She was pushing all of us, including herself, to reach higher goals. And that was something not a lot of my teachers ever did in high school. She's one of the only ones I can think of that I felt like pushed me to where I felt confident in my ability to tackle challenging things in the future, especially school, college, because I hadn't been challenged that way before. I was really good at busy work, really good at getting A's and passing and cramming and forgetting things. And she taught me the importance of education. And I think that's the bottom line. She taught me the whole purpose of education and how to continue learning through my whole life. And I think that's the most valuable skill that we can gain. She did this by being enthusiastic, not only about the subjects, but about us and teaching and learning. She used every minute of class every time, so you knew you were going into work. And she challenged us. She gave us assignments and tests and things that would stretch us. And by completing them with her help, my anxieties about the future, which you have a lot of as a junior in high school, were calmed, and I felt more capable, and not only to function in college, but just as a human being in our society. So she helped us reach the high expectations that she had for us, and I love that it wasn't impossible, it wasn't out of reach, because she was a facilitator for us to reach those goals. And everyone knew you had to work hard in her class to get good grades, but she would help you. For example, like if you came to class without pen and paper, she would give it to you so you could take notes. While she was lecturing, she would take notes on the board that we could copy. And I loved that because it showed me there are, you know, so many ways to teach things that can be helpful. And that was really helpful because it, one, taught us how to take good notes, and two, it showed that she understood what it was like to learn something for the first time. By doing that, we didn't have to listen and write at the same time, and we were able to just focus on what she was doing and get what we needed down. So she was there to like facilitate us becoming better learners. And another thing that I noticed from her that I loved was that in almost every class, she used examples from her life. She would just say them like she had them perfectly happen for, like she's had these experiences that perfectly match up with the lesson. But of course that wasn't true, that was just her life experiences. And it showed me that learning is everywhere, that we can find it, you know, everything we learn about, we can find in real life, and we can learn from real life. And it finally made it click for me how to apply school and why and where I could apply it. Because I think that's a question on every student's mind as they go through school. Like, when do I use this? How does it apply to me? Why does it matter? And she made it click. And I feel like that is so important for students. And what clicked was just that learning is valuable if I make it valuable. And that's something I really want to give to my students. I want them to develop the mindset of learning in the way of taking what they can from every situation they're in, whether it's a subject they like or not, whether it's a place they want to be in their lives or not, even after high school, that they look at the situation they're in and say, okay, I'm in this situation, what can I take from it? What can I apply? What can I use? And I love that skill, and it helped me so much in my college career and in my choice to be a teacher. because I really want students to not have to waste their education like I feel like I wasted a lot of mine. And so if I can give them that, then I'll be proud of me, I'll be proud for Mrs. Leek, and I hope she'll be proud too. And I just want to be the teacher that isn't, you know, to be the teacher that teaches lessons that aren't necessarily said. And I feel like Mrs. Leek did quite a lot of that. And I still learned about psychology at the same time. So thank you, Mrs. Leek, and I'll